Yes. Here's what's on today. Oh no!
Before we can make this noise. Here's what's on today.
Yes.
Yes, there's a bit of Dennis the Menace for you. Stay tuned for that. He's always a good one, Dennis, isn't he?
Very good. A good value for money. They're Looney Tunes. There's Kawali Coyote in Roadrunner.
Before that's all, folks, though, there's a bit of Basil Brush. Boom, boom!
Boom, boom!
And of course, Ready to Ghost. That's usually on Dick and Dom in a bungalow till 12, and right now,
let's meet the bungalow heads.
Yes, they're here! Come on!
Here they are!
Ring that doorbell, bungalow head! Yes!
Oh, is Stanley. That the door?
It's Stanley!
Stanley! What's wrong with the door today?
Shut the door!
Close!
Is that it? Stanley!
It's like Crossroads.
Who are England playing today?
Bratislava.
You what?
Slovakia, whatever.
Bratislava? What football team's Bratislava?
Hey, by the way, we've got very rude. Hang on a minute, who did your hair this morning? The hair fairy.
Look at that.
Oi, yeah, have a look at it. Can you see that?
Look at that hair.
Look at that. What is going on there?
What is that?
Is that Tony Blackburn's wig?
No, I don't know. It's natural.
Have you actually grown it? Done it today? Styled it?
No.
Stanley, anyway, sorry about him.
We didn't actually shake hands. Oh, sorry about that. Stan the man. I'm sorry.
Stanley, you are 10 years old.
Yeah.
You can beat out a musical rhythm on your chest.
Uh-huh.
Please do so. I'm getting it.
Keep going. All right, I'm bored now. Off you go. Thanks, cheers, Stanley. Oh, is that the doorbell?
Here, Stanley's brother's here!
No!
Yes, Edward!
Edward! It's goes down there.
It's Stanley's brother!
And you can tell they're brothers, because here's Ed, who's just as bad.
Oh, the door! Shut!
Stupid door. Crossroads. No! Don't bust the bungo.
It's okay now, it's fixed.
Ladies and gentlemen, Edward is 8 years old. Is this correct?
Yeah.
Put it there, pal.
Put it there, pal.
Now, apparently, it says here that you like to spend as much time as possible looking at the world from an upside-down position, correct?
What yeah. earth are you talking about, you grotty little man?
So
show
us. Go on, then, show us.
Okay.
What you just did there, you just did a roly-poly.
I know.
Hang on a minute, come here.
Yeah.
Right.
Like that.
What's
look
it like
the,
now?
Look at it upside down.
Hey, what's it like now? Do you like that?
See it?
Do you like that?
How does it look?
Hey, like, tell
is
can we good? Turn the camera
yeah.
upside down?
Yeah, he likes
so
it upside
just,
down. There we are.
There you go. If we turn the camera upside down.
Right.
There he is.
There he is, upside
you're the right
down.
Way round now. You're the right way round. That's okay, isn't
drop
it?
Drop him now, mate.
There
drop him now, mate.
You can just go
Edward,
down.
What's the most go annoying thing about your brother Stanley? All right, stay on the floor.
No, stay down.
It's where you belong. Stay down.
So,
what's next the most... to that dirty carpet.
What's the most annoying thing about Stanley?
He's an idiot.
Right, we'll
he's
go over idiot. There and beat him up for us.
Go on, beat him up. Stop. Carry on. Stop. That's it.
Hey, we've got more brothers to fight with.
No.
The first one, Milo. This is one brother, one half of
him. Oh, Milo. And how are the rest of them?
They're okay.
How's Fizz?
Stupid dog.
Fizz, well, they're okay at the moment.
How's Jake?
He's good.
Are you a comedian?
I'm not really, not yet.
Don't you want to come in? It doesn't smell. It's okay. Milo, lovely to meet you.
Yep.
No. Sorry, Milo.
Sorry about her.
Sorry, now, Smilo, Milo. Smilo, Milo, to the camera. Yes,
Milo, you're 10 years old, yes?
Yep.
You're double jointed and can bend your leg right back.
I can, yes.
Go on then.
It's like... Also, if my brother was here, I can get my leg right.
Bring the brother in early!
Okay, yeah, he's only little. Sorry, little Harvey.
Right, you show us. Big Milo! Show us what you can do to little Harvey.
Okay, right. Harvey, you stand there.
Oh, big boss.
Three.
Oh! Can I have a go?
Go on, stand sideways and do it so everyone can see. Okay. Stand sideways. Go on, ready? I tell you what, it would be really funny if you accidentally smacked him in the face. No, but don't try it. Please go sit there, Milo. Now, everyone,
It's a little one. This is the youngest.
Everyone, there's no music.
Shh.
It's the youngest bungalow head ever. Tell us how old you are, Harvey.
7.
Oh. Rock-a-bye, baby, on the treetops.
7 years old.
Wait. Milo, Harvey, can you shake my hand?
Harvey, shake my hand. Harvey, you're our youngest ever bungalow head. You can squeeze your tongue.
No.
Thank you, bungalow. You can squeeze your tongue until it clicks.
Yeah. Oh, that's sweet. Nice.
Sweet, to have a bit of a closer listen. Do it again.
Yeah. What a nut. Do you do that for your family at Christmas?
Stop patronising!
Sorry, mate.
Harvey!
Harvey.
Hey,
sorry about that.
Harvey and Milo! The good thing is, we've got more brothers to fight.
Yes!
One, Patrick!
Let's just get them both in there fighting.
Go on, go on, fight.
Go on, go on, fight.
Stop it! Get off him! Right, you hold them
stop
back!
There. Right, you stay there!
Right!
You vicious beast!
This is Patrick, yes? Patrick's 10 years old. Yeah. Patrick can bend his finger and make one joint stick out while the others stay in the same place. Do it, mate!
Right. Now, have you stopped? Stop it!
No,
you'll lose bungalow points. No, you won't win anything. You'll get nothing. Bad man.
We didn't mean fight.
Good, there we are. What we meant is love each other.
Yeah. 9 years old, yeah?
9 years old, and apparently it says here, you hate ham and butter. Is that jam and butter or ham and butter?
Well, you hate it.
Ham.
Ham and butter. We've got a lovely sandwich for you.
Get it eaten, mate!
Go on, and you'll win some bungalow points.
Eat it,
go on. You got some ham there and butter. Go on.
All of that.
Whack it in your face.
Oh.
Go on, Jamie. Go on, Jamie.
Go on.
No, go on. Get it in. Get it in. Go on, whack it in more. Go on, get it in. They've all got one. What was that?
I don't know. It was wind.
Okay, now can we just say?
I think it was supposed to be a cheer, but it just didn't get.
Yeah, I'll check.
It was like their bottoms hitting a marble staircase.
Just slapping against a marble staircase. Hey, can we just say, all of our bungalow heads of it have got one thing in common. Look at their hairstyles, they're awful. Come on, come on, can we start here? Shut up, I haven't asked you to speak. Sit down. Look. There, have a look. Look, bad. Look, it's all stuck up at the side. Look.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Look at the state of that.
You're cheeking him. You're giving him cheek already, Stanley.
You're being bad.
These are the bungalow heads. We give them points for things that they do that we like. We take their points away for things that we do that we don't like.
Did you? Well done.
Thank you.
I'm going to ask you
a question first, though, Jamie, right?
Go on, Jamie.
Okay, Jamie? I've got some socks on, yeah? And they're honking. They stink. How many days have you been wearing them for? Guess.
A week.
How many?
A week.
I'm afraid you're wrong.
A year.
Yes, correct. Well done, Patrick. They've been for 1 year.
That means Patrick gets the bungalow points. You get 15 bungalow points for telling me.
15 bungalow points.
I've been wearing my socks for a year. So don't be cheeky, because we might take them away, yeah?
Okay, so that's exactly how it works. We've got a scoreboard, and we give away prizes. If one of you... Don't go... What did you just do to me? No. Go on, do it again. Do it again.
No.
Do it again.
No.
Bad man.
All right. If you come third,
stop it. What are you doing? If you come third today, you'll win this.
Oh, it's a 3-month subscription to MG Enthusiast magazine.
Yeah. You like that, don't you?
If you've got a nice old MG in the driveway, you'll be able to get along with it with that magazine.
Ah, it's a good one. Yeah, you like
it. Second prize, if you second tomorrow, you'll get this. Micro-pet!
Oh, yeah! Yeah, my year! Now, listen, you don't look excited now, but they're going to be the Christmas number one. Be more excited now. Sarcastic little... Anyway, and if you... No, we haven't got it. It's disappeared.
Well, the main prize is...
Yeah, the main prize.
Let's put our hands on our hips in astonishment. The main prize, the star prize, has disappeared. Everyone put your hands on your hips. Well, unbelievable!
Yeah. And the video.
Come and have a look. Oi, come and have a look at this. The video phone's gone as well.
There's a note. Ooh. It says here, there should be a garden out there, Tor very much love da burglar. He's taken it.
He's been back again.
Hang on, talking with a burglar.
He's brought back the telly.
The TV's back.
The old TV's back.
Hey, look. Oh. Hey, it won't be a couple of weeks before that's broken again.
Hey, put your hands on your hips. The star prize has appeared again. Let's have a look at it.
Here it is. Patch on.
Ooh. Ooh, now that's ugly, isn't it?
It's not very nice. No. Not very nice at all. There we are. Just clicking effect number. Hey, listen, you guys, it's your turn. Help yourself some breakfast. Make some breakfast. Go on and make some breakfast. We're going to tell you guys how you can get in contact with us today here in the bungalow.
What we want you to do, if you want to play Boingy Boingy today, yes, you know the game where Dom of the Yukon bounces up and down. You have to guess how many times he bounces before he falls off his trumpet. Call in on this number, 0845 900 2222. 0845 900 2222. Look at all the little small print there. Get your glasses on, have a look what it says. That's
Yes, it's not very interesting, but it's really boring.
25p, blah, blah, blah.
So call in. Also call in if you just want to talk to us, because you can do that. Listen to them.
Yes, if you just want to talk to us.
Yes, and also email us. The email address is bungalow@bbc.co.uk. That's the British Broadcasting Corporation. Lord Reed founded the BBC back in 1940 with the Inform, Educate and Entertain.
Shut up. Four of these to give away. Yes, four. If you email in four Robbie Williams books.
And also, do they do the right thing that they're made for? Yep, they work. They work absolutely fine.
Yeah. It's a... Ow!
Brilliant.
It's a bit of a boys' day today, isn't it? Boys' books, boys!
Yeah, last week we had lots of girls in here. Girls! Boys. What do you think of girls? What do you think of girls?
Come here. Edward's made me a slice of toast. Edward, thank you very much. Oh, that's very kind. Oh, right, time to watch your
program. Come on, program. There's another tape in here.
The blue panted man is on. Sorry about that.
Right, sit down.
Anyone for a slice of toast? Good night.
Yeah, he's got mine.
Good night, ladies.
But of course.
Oh, that was Yvonne of the Yukon. This is Dominic Woods.
I love you, mother.
Here are a bunch of girls. And this is Edward. Edward.
That's not me. That's Harvey. That's Harvey. That's
Edward. Eddie baby.
No, it's not really working with him. He's too clever for us.
Yeah.
No,
you're too clever, you boys. England!
Stand down.
Sally, who are England playing again tonight?
Czechoslovakia. Yeah.
Slovakia. You just mean Slovakia, don't you?
Yeah.
Yes, you do. Shall we have a look what else is on the channels?
Okay, let me just flick the channel.
No, it's under there.
Oh, there it is.
Press that button, see what's on. It's not the Saturday show.
No, it certainly is not.
Hang on.
I must have got the wrong channel. That was the...
Oh, yeah, yeah. It's the Queen and Ozzy Osbourne. And they're beating each other up.
Your Majesty.
It's Her Royal Highness. It's Her Royal Behindness.
Oh, God, there's a car waiting to get across.
Oh, they're at the crossing. Look, do you think he's going to help her up now? Let the car go by.
Oh, wow, there we are.
Right, everyone on your feet, it's time for the boingy boingy.
This is the part of the show where you guys get to watch Dom of the Yukon. He's there ready and waiting in the garden, ready to bounce up and down on his trampoline. You guys call in and try and work out how many times he's going to bounce.
Look, I've been given this, right? And it's supposed to be four tickets to Disney's Beauty and the Beast on Ice. Look what it really is. Nothing. Absolutely. You get a gold envelope if you win today.
It's a very nice gold envelope. Very nice. Not anymore, it's not. Okay, so basically it is, you win Beauty and the Beast on Ice. Callers. Oh, no, we can have a look at it.
Oh, can we? Can we?
Ooh.
Oh, look at it.
I love that.
Oh. 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 It's all
that's nice, isn't it? Beauty and the Beast.
Yeah, friend, do you like Beauty and the Beast?
Lovely. Sophie Proctor, hello.
Hello, Sophie.
Hello, Sophie. All right. How are you today, my little bummikins?
Do you say anything else, Bob?
Pardon?
Oh, yeah, she does.
What she says, pardon. Right, then, Sophie, how many bounces do you think he's going to do before he falls off his trumpet?
10.
How many?
10.
10, OK, thank you.
And my caller should be, he remembers, Anthony Cogan. Hello!
Hello.
How are you? How are you?
Fine.
Are you OK today?
Leave him alone.
Yeah.
I want you to go jugga 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 jugga. Go on. Say jugga 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 jugga.
How many bounces off Neon's trumpet?
19.
Oh. Now, you can stop doing that right now.
Hang on a minute, everyone.
You stop that.
Leave him alone.
He's doing that behind my head.
It doesn't matter.
It does. I'm going to deduct 20 bungalow points from you.
Right.
20.
Stop doing that. Bungalow heads, choose your teams. Do you want 10 on my team or 19 with Dom? Choose your
19.
How many bounces? Choose your teams. 19. Come on. 10 or 19?
19. 19. 19. 19. 19. Right. 19.
No, it could be 10 bounces. 10. You want to go 10?
19.
Patrick wants to go with you.
Then.
Go on, then.
Come on, Patrick. Nice team, mate.
Yeah.
Let's have a look. We've chosen our teams. How many bounces is Dom of the Ukulele?
Oh,
he's checking his pants. Oh, my word.
Oh, he kept his hat down there.
His hat was in his pants. One, two, three, four, five, six.
He got bored.
That means, Sophie, we've won!
No!
Sophie, let's hear you again.
No!
We've won!
No.
Sophie, you've just won 4 tickets to see Disney's Beauty and the Beast on Ice.
Yeah.
not stage or setup at all.
Right, I'll tell you what. I'm just going to send you the ripped envelope instead.
What we're going to do now, we're going to play a game that one of you guys is actually in it.
We've got an email. Oh, by the way, for the Boingy Boingy, because you all chose my team, you all got 10, you all get 15 points each.
Yay!
So you are losers. Well done. That's Jamie. That's Milo. That's Patrick. Nice one, guys.
Yay.
Yes, we've got an email in from a caller, listener. Dear Dick and Dom.
Carry on.
Hello.
Carry on.
I've just invented
an amazing new game for your show.
Just invented an amazing new game for your show. It's called The Mummy.
The Mummy.
Mummy. Wait for it.
Mummy.
Wait for it.
Stop it, Edward. You have two teams. Listen! You have two. I'll explain to you. You come and listen. You've got to listen. You have teams of two. One person volunteers to be the mummy, then the other person has to wrap the second person up in toilet tissue.
Yep.
The winner is the team where the mummy has got the most toilet paper around them, and there's 20 bungalow points on offer. Thank you to Louise Rigglesford from Rigglesford. Rigglesford from Rigglesford. For that.
Hey, I know.
Yes.
I'm going to go to the toilet.
I'm going to go to the toilet. Right, while he's doing that, I'll choose the teams. We're going to have Harvey and Jamie on one team. Little people. I can't believe we found people as small as Dom. Look at this, brilliant. And we're going to have Stanley and Milo on another team. So you come over here. And you other guys, you go and sit down on the sofa.
I'm going to be the Milo.
Right, go.
Good.
Okay. No, you're all playing.
Shall I wrap you up?
Let me read Louise's email again. Yes, you're all playing. So, Patrick, you go with Milo and Stanley, and Edward, you go with my little people's team. You're all little people on that team. It's the little people against the big people. Okay, there's your toilet rolls.
Milo's the smallest.
Right, listen.
Shall we wrap him up?
Come and stand over here. Come and stand over here. You've got 60 seconds. 60 seconds. 30 seconds. 30 seconds. Oh, we're only giving you 30 seconds in which to wrap your team member up that you've chosen to be the mummy in as much toilet tissue as possible.
I'll do the legs.
Are you ready, guys?
No.
Oh, tough. Yes.
Right, have you chosen your mummies?
Yes.
Your 30 seconds start now.
Go on.
Wrap them up in toilet tissue. Wrap them up in toilet tissue. Come on. Wrap them up in toilet tissue.
Take your DMV.
Don't you think it was a well-explained game?
I think we did a very good job.
We really explained that game well, didn't we?
I mean, it probably is an awesome player's game as well.
It's the viewers' game of the week with 12 seconds left. Come on, wrap that toilet paper round. Come on, let's see you. Wrap it round. Come on, get some. Oh, look at the state of this, man. Right.
Yeah.
Louise, 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 Louise. Louise. Wait, wait, wait. Louise. We won't be playing your game again.
But now, listen, the reason why we don't ask you to write in with ideas for games is because they're all rubbish. Look. That's why we got a team of people who come up with ideas for the show.
Look at the state of that. Right, look. Milo, you've got a bit round you. And on the little people's team, they've absolutely got...
What have you done? Why didn't you play the game?
You just beat...
Harvey, come here. Harvey.
Let him explain.
Little Harvey. Go on.
Right,
enough. Everybody, come and have a sit down now, because we're going to play another game in a little bit.
We're going to give you 5 points.
The small change hunt. You've got to search for some small change around the bungalow. That was a bit of a rubbish.
Oh, hee haw. Maintenant, aujourd'hui, je suis dididom. Un artiste. Parce que j'aime la France. J'aime la. Oh, hee haw.
Lovey. What does that mean?
No idea, mate. Just looked it up in a book.
Hey, lovey. Have you captured the essence of my beauty?
Oh, yes.
My sweet complexion.
Oui, oui.
And the devilishly playful glimmer in either eye.
Oui, 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 oui.
Show me, lovey. I'm so excited. Show me. You animal.
Oh.
That doesn't look anything like me, lovey. It's got red paint all over my face.
Oh, well, come here. Now he looks like you.
That's stupendous! Thank you so much! Oh, my portrait's been painted! Look at that!
It's the typical cheap shake bungalow stunt. It's time to get ready for the small change hunt.
Get ready for the small change hunt. Yes, it's time for the small change hunt. Around the bungalow, there are lots of pennies waiting for you guys. You've got to find as many of them as possible. The person that finds the most small change will be the winner of 20 bungalow points.
No.
My word. Plus, I've also heard, legend has it...
Wait! I found some, and here's
not yet. Yeah, but the game hasn't started.
Thanks, Stanley.
Yes, the game hasn't started yet. What are you...
Now, Harvey finally managed to get the idea of the game and decided to wrap himself up in toilet rolls. Harvey, mate, you've got to play this game like this, OK? You can't take the toilet roll off, OK?
OK.
Just nod, we can't hear you.
Legend has it, as I was just saying, there's a pound coin somewhere in the... If you find the pound coin, you could keep it.
Yay!
Or you could exchange it for some bungalow points.
Yay.
Are you ready?
You've got 45 seconds on the clock for the small
starting
change.
Starting! Go!
Find that money, come on.
Oh, there you go.
Shh. What are you doing? Stanley.
Yeah.
Time is up.
Game all right. Everyone stand in a long line. Stand in a
long line.
Stand in a long line.
You've only got 6p though normally. You've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 20, 30, 40, 46p.
Let's just count yours.
10, 20, 30, 4,
42.
6, 48 there.
No, wait, Harvey.
How did you do, Harvey?
So, can you... Harvey's got nothing. Do you know why you got nothing, Harvey?
Yeah.
You've got a bog roll wrapped around your head. Hang on a minute. But for being a good sport, Harvey, we're going to give you 8 bungalow points.
Yay, Harvey. And look, Stanley got 56 pence.
Stanley!
Wait with your pound coin. That's 20 bungalow points to Stanley. And Edward, now, say it again.
One pound!
Right, Edward, turn around. You can now either keep the pound for yourself or you can exchange it for 30 bungalow points.
Bungalow points.
Bungalow points! Right, well, I'll have the pound coin. Thank you. No! And you've got 30 bungalow points.
Yay! Well done, well awesome. Done. And we're going to be... Oh, what have you just broken? Come here. Look, what have you done? Milo. Milo, don't touch it.
Oh, you've broken the bowl.
Look what he's done. I'll tell you what. We're going to go and get this cleaned up while you hear a bad joke.
Listen, I'm going to take some of this toilet roll back to the toilet. Come on, because...
No, you can't go in there. Don't go in there.
You go and give it to Turtle's Head. There we are.
What's black and white and red all over? A penguin with nappy rash. Oh, get out of it!
Milo, come on here, Milo. What are you doing? What have you been doing in there?
I don't know.
What, you've been whacking the turtle's head?
No.
Yeah, you have. You've been whacking that turtle's head, haven't you? Yeah. He's been whacking the turtle.
I'll tell you what, let's just have a look at the scoreboard, see how we're doing today here in the bungalow. Here's the scoreboard, here's how everyone's doing right here in the bungalow.
It's a madhouse in the bungalow today, but Stanley's already got 20.
Yeah, Edward's doing well with 30 points.
Milo, Jake, Viz, Doodles has got 15.
Yeah, and then we've got Harvey with 8.
Patrick with 10.
And Jamie has got 15.
You're all doing well, guys.
Hey, listen, guys, here's the deal. Why don't you all just sit down for a minute and stop it? Go on, all just sit down. Calm down. Go on. There you go.
Ready?
Ready, move on.
Spotted Dick.
Here you go.
Time for Spotted Dick.
Do you know who he is?
Do you know who I am?
Do you know who this guy is? Every single week, we send this chirpy chappy to an area in this country.
Yes, we've already all been all over the country. Look, lots of dicks all over the country.
Even in the sea.
Yes. And now it's the turn of... The Funk on the Time is all mine. Newcastle. Stick it on.
Mike Irwell, Alan Shearer, Dick and Dom's best mates, Ant and Dec. Yes, we're in Newcastle. And once again, it's time for me to say, do you know who I am? What's my name?
Can't remember. It's from my sister.
What's for your sister?
Autograph, please.
Well, you can't have an autograph till you tell me who I am. Do you know who I am?
Yeah, you're Dick.
Dick, nice one, mate. You're official. Dick, there's your sticker. Think about it.
Because my little sister's a big fan, that's all I can remember.
Well, your little sister's not getting an autograph until you remember my name.
Please.
No, my name's not please. You. Yes, you. Do you know my name? Come on, you do. It's in there somewhere. What's my name? Dick. Did you say Dick? Well, you get the sticker, sir. Nice one. You spotted Dick. I'm in Newcastle all day, so come on. I'll just stand here with you until you remember. What's my name?
Richard.
No, it's not Richard. What is it really?
Dick.
You did it. You spotted Dick.
So come here often then.
No, no, you're not supposed to ask me questions. I'm asking you, do you know who I am?
I can't remember.
Girls. One of you must know my name. Come on, what's my name?
Richard.
No, not Richard. What's the name short for Richard?
Dick.
Yes, you have done it. You have spotted. Hold on, stick it. Dick. Ah, you two. Do you know who I am?
Dick.
What?
Dick!
Louder!
Dick!
Yes! You both spotted Dick on Dick and Dom in Dath Bungalow. Goodbye. Now, this lot have been staring at me for ages, so hello, guys. Firstly, can you all do me a little tap dance? Yes, like that. Secondly, do you know who I am?
Richard!
That was just a noise. What's my name?
Richard!
It's not Richard. What is it? Yes! You! I'll give it you! You officially spotted Dick! The lot of you! Nice one! You! Do you know who I am?
You're... Dick!
Yes! Winner! Spotted Dick! Hello. I'm going to stick this big microphone in your face and I'm going to say, do you know who I am?
Dick!
Yo, yes, that's Dick, thank you. Do you know who I am?
I've seen you on the telly. Can I tell you your name though?
Go on, think.
It might be like Rich or Richard.
Yeah, nearly. What's the short name for Rich? I shouldn't give you any help really, but...
Short name for Rich, Dick.
Yes! You did it, you did it. A sticker.
It's Rich or something. I can't remember.
Yeah.
I'm getting there.
A short name for Richard. Come on.
Dick?
Yes! Yes! You spotted Dick! You get your autograph! Yes! Newcastle, I am proud of you. You spotted Dick 10 times. Nice one. So now back to the pink-haired freak.
because I've got hair and I'm pink and poppy because it's pink and poppy. Now, Dicky, well done, Nate. Well done. 10 out of 10 people knew exactly who he was. Here is a Dick pie chart. This is Dick, it's a pie chart, and this is just a margin of error. Yes, there we go. But generally, you've got 100%. 100%. Now, also, let's just work out exactly how famous that makes him. He'll probably live in a place like this. There we go. Look at that lovely palace. Oh.
The Taj Mahal.
Leave it. Oh, look at that lovely, lovely car you drive. An old banger, I think.
There we are, just
like his mother. There we go. And also, oh, look at all his friends. Very happy to see him as well. Oh. And he will probably be as famous as the planet Earth. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and twirls, we are in the presence of royalty.
Royalty? Oh, yeah.
Ooh. So can we bring in the ladies? Come on. Come on, footmen. here he is. Oh, corgis and everything. There we are. Thank you very much. And now, everyone, bow down.
Bow down?
Oh!
Yo, dog.
We are not worthy.
We are not worthy.
Oh, they're my shades. I wonder where they went.
We are not worthy.
Oh, and hold your corgi.
Oh, I'm not bowing. You're awesome. We are not worthy.
All right, shut the music off. You're watching Dick and Dom.
Oh, the dog's going! Dom, come back!
Yeah,
Dom,
Dick and Dom,
no, Dom, here! Corgi, Dog. Dog.
Well, I think that one kind of worked well. The idea was good, but I don't think we really pulled it off well enough.
No, there
we
are. It's a corgi! Oh, I've just hit him with the stace.
Oh, he's off.
Right, hey, listen, come
over
here.
Give him a shave back.
Come here, I can't see you. Come over here. Between me and you, pass me the telephone, Dom.
Yeah.
I need the telephone. Look, bit of a problem again. Only between me and you, remember this. Only between you. Don't let the bungalow heads here. Don't let Dom here. Thanks for the phone. Right, I want you to call in and tell me how to solve the problem the moose has got. The weather's been changing, right? And look. The moose is ill!
Snotty moose.
He's got a cold. What are we gonna do to solve this? Look at that. Look.
Snotty, snot. Yes.
Tell us how we can cure this problem on 0845 900 2222. 0845 900 2222. Press 6. You'll get through to the bungalow. And that's that. So, call in now.
Here, look. Dicky.
Yes, we've
got some emails here, and I want Martin to read this. Martin?
Who's Martin? My dad's called. What are you talking about, you
Oh, no, sorry, it's wrong, Martin. Get off! No, Stanley.
Yeah.
Stanley, there you go. Do you want to be called Martin for the rest of the show?
No.
No, all right then. Stanley, read that out for us, please. It's an email. Go on, read it out.
Read it.
Hi, it's Catherine Martin in Newcastle. Just saying that Stanley is well cute.
You've got a fancy puppy. It says, hello, it's Catherine in Newcastle. Just saying that Stanley is well cute and so is his brother as well. I'm going to keep watching the show just because of those two.
So we've got another one here. Okay, now this one's from Mum Taz Dizal and says, hi, my sister wakes up and watches before 9 a.m. to watch the show. Everything's great. There we are. Well done, you get one as well.
Is that all it says?
Yeah, that's it. But there we are. Well done. You can both get those books.
Send in an exciting email. I'm sure we had one better than that.
Yeah, well, here's the email address. Yeah. bungalow@bbc.co.uk.
bungalow@bbc.co.uk. Time for a bit of boom boom action now. Yes, our video is here from the video cabinet. And it's BB, it's Big B, it's Basil Brush.
Let's just check it. It does still work.
We need to press eject. We need to press eject.
What is that? What's that?
What is it? What's that? What is it?
Get it out! Get it
what
out!
What is it?
Get it out!
There's
get
a
out.
Spider! Get rid of the spider! Get the spider!
Get out! Get out!
Get him! Get him! Get the spider! Get
the spider!
No! There's a spider! Look at the spider! There's a spider!
What's the program?
Basil Brush! Yes! Basil Brush, quick! Hey, spider!
Your phone's broken! Hey,
welcome back to Dick and Dom in the bungalow. That was Basil Brush.
Yes.
It's very funny, isn't
it's
it?
It's very funny. And these are our bungalow heads for the day. Hello, say hello and wave.
Hello, bungalow heads. Yes, these are bungalow heads. We give them points for things that they do that we like. We take them away for things that they do that we don't like. Yes. Let's get that wrong.
And yeah, well done. And we've actually got a scoreboard, and this is exactly how they're doing today in the bungalow. Let's have a look at the scoreboard.
Yes, we've been awarding them points all morning so far. Stay tuned till 12 to find out who the winner is. But at the moment, Stanley's got 20.
Eddie, baby, he looks like he's in the lead with 30.
Milo, Jake, Fizz and Doodles have got 15.
OK, and moving on, we've got 8. Harvey.
Come on, Harvey, you need
Come
some
on,
points.
Harvey.
Patrick's got 10.
There we go. And Jamie has got 15. So there we are. Eddie Baby's in the lead at the moment. Eddie Baby.
Go on, Eddie,
Eddie
Baby.
Eddie Baby, how do you feel?
I feel rubbish.
Oh.
I want to get guns.
All right, then. OK. Well, who's at the bottom? Harvey. Harvey and Eddie Baby. You swap points. Well done.
No.
What? What are you?
No.
You can win.
Oh, no, I don't want to.
You don't want to win?
I will. I want to win.
Shush. What's the point in you all being here? What are you here for? You don't want to win a team.
I'll tell you what, though. If you do,
come
third, remember, you'll get this: a 3-month subscription to the MG magazine.
Now you like that, don't you?
Yeah.
The MG Enthusiast magazine. A dream midget.
Would you like a dream midget?
Yeah,
no.
Prize, yeah.
Right? That's the third prize. The second prize is this. Look at that, micro pets!
Oh, absolutely beautiful they are.
Come on, you're going to want to win them, haven't you?
Loads of
money. You want to win the TV.
Yeah. You want to win the TV?
Well, that's what the first prize is.
Have a look. Have a look, this is the TV.
Do we win it today?
And some Lego as well, look at that. And you win Angel Dick. There you are. But right now, let's see if you can earn yourself some more bungalow points as we play this.
Sweet face,
the sticky sweet rice. Do you know, that silly B-roll, isn't it,
Matt? Yeah, B-roll.
B-roll.
Yes, the sweet face challenge, where we take the person at the top of the leaderboard, which is Eddie Baby.
Come here, Eddie Baby.
Edward, you firstly decide who you'd like to play with in this game. It can be any of the bungalow heads, or me or Dom.
Jamie.
Jamie! Right, and now I want to tell you what you have to do in the game. There's two bowls of sweets here. Oh. All you're going to do in 30 seconds is stick as many sweets as possible to your face.
Not yet.
It's the sweet face race. Are you ready?
The time's on the clock. Ready, go!
Sweet face, come on, here we go. Stick them sweets to your face.
Come on. Cheer. Stick them to your face. Stick them to your face. Lick them, stick them to your face. Stick them to your face. No, they're going to be stuck to your face properly. Now, what are you doing?
No, you can't do that.
No. You've got to. Look.
Lick and stick.
Like this. Watch. Like this. No, don't eat them.
Oh, now look what he's doing.
Like this.
You got 2 seconds. 1-0. Now, Jamie. What were your tactics there?
I don't think you really had any, did you?
What were you trying to do there?
Well, you were trying to shove as many in your face as possible, weren't you?
Go on, Jamie, we'll let you eat as many as possible.
Shove them in your face, come on. There you go.
That is Edward. Look, Edward got 2.
Hey!
20 points to Edward.
Well done.
Go on, son.
I'll tell you what, we'll be playing more of that tomorrow. And now a word from our sponsors.
Dick and Dom,
we've never heard of them. Well, at 90, I'm out of touch with all these young things, aren't I?
What on earth did those old grannies say? Can we see those old grannies again?
You know what? I'd love to see the grannies again.
I'd like to hear what they exactly said about us.
Go on, Granny.
Dick and Dom,
we've never heard of them.
Well, at 90, I'm out of touch with all these young things, aren't I?
Young whippersnappers.
She's very sweet. There's no excuse. She should have the CBBC channel. She should have the CBBC channel.
Get the torches.
Every single Saturday this happens. What's wrong with the place? Sorry, the generator has broken down today. It's broken. Yeah. It always does that every time about this time, regular as clockwork. Yes. It always breaks down. And the funny thing is...
How'd you get the time off
down,
the bracelet?
Hey? Yeah, sorry. Funny thing is, whenever it breaks down, objects...
Yes.
Float around the bungalow.
What's going to happen here is... Fifteen objects are going to fly through the bungalow, guys, yeah? And you've got to try and remember as many of them as possible, yes?
Ow!
Either.
Ow!
Right?
Ow!
We've got your boards, and you've got to at the end of seeing all the objects fly past, you've got to remember as many as possible and write them all down. The person with the most, don't write them down now, because you haven't seen any yet, have you? Hold up. Put the boards down. Edward, put the boards down a minute, because we haven't started yet. Thank you. Right. What's going to happen? Like I said, 15 objects are going to fly through the sky. Here we go. Try and remember as many as possible. Ready?
Can we write them down?
Don't write them down now. No. After. The first object, please. What's going on here?
Today's objects are this tasty pineapple, an attractive flower pot, this handy tennis racket, quacking duck.
Who's that there?
Go to space in this rocket. A lickable stamp. Light up your life with a lampshade.
Who are you?
A crunchy carrot. Tick-tock, it's a clock.
No.
Saddle up on our rocking horse. Call Mum, here's a telephone. Snuggle up with our teddy bear. What's up, Doc? It's a bunny rabbit.
Cuddly toy!
Play your favourite...
Right.
Lunch up, I'll fix it. Oi, oi.
What on earth went on there?
Hey, I've just come back from fixing the generator. Who are them?
Pass me a board.
Who are they? A load of people in black outfits who just walked past me.
What's supposed to happen there is when the voiceover man says what the object is, the object's supposed to appear. But anyway, right, guys, you've got 30 seconds now to try and remember as many of those objects as possible. Write them down on the board.
Don't start.
Oh, come on.
Don't start.
Hey.
Where do you write them?
Ow. Are you doing it? Just write them down. Go! Come on! Oh, come on, write them down.
30 seconds, come on.
Come on, you can do it. You can do it. Come on, Eddie. Anyway, you can remember it.
Yeah, I can remember it.
Stanley, come on, how many have you got so far?
20 seconds left.
I've got three!
You got well done. Oh, that's not very good, is it? Come on, even more. Think of all those objects.
Read it.
I'll give you all a clue. There was a rocket.
All right.
There you go, that's one you've all got.
Yay!
10 seconds.
Come on, folks.
Wow!
Five, four, three, two, one, zero. Right, throw all your pens at us now, guys.
Throw the pens at us. Hold your boards out like that.
Everyone, line up.
Come on, let's have a look. No, they can stay there.
No, they're going to line up.
Come on. Let's have a look. Okay, you can sit down. No, we'll just sit down. Okay, so we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 there. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 6 for Milo. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for Stanley. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 over here for Brian. No, it's not Patrick, okay? We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 over here for Eddie, baby. And we've got... What do you do? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 again for Jamie.
No.
And Harvey's only got 3.
That's not true.
Oh, poor little Harvey.
That means there's about 4 people that have got 6.
I've got 7.
You've got 7?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
He's right.
Well done,
Patrick. Patrick, well done. You win 20 bungalow points.
Yes. He's learned that one word.
It doesn't matter anyway, because we're going to go and watch a programme now. Dennis and Menace, anyone? Yep?
Yeah!
Good, okay, right, well, in it goes into the machine, working as usual. Press play. Oh, a little bit of Dennis and Menace there. You guys looked interested by that, didn't you? There we go. Hey, it's Dick and Dom in the Bungalow.
Yes.
I'm Dom.
I'm Dick.
Hey, that's Dick.
Yes, and he's Dom.
And we are Dick and Dom.
Yes.
And right now, thank you very much, Bungalow. We are in the Bungalow, and we've got all the best programmes for you. We're going to show you what's coming up later on.
Yes, let's have a look. There's a bit of Rent-A-Ghost in just about 2 minutes.
Time, how exciting. After Rent-A-Ghost, you can see some Looney Tunes.
Yeah, that's nearly all, folks. But before that is all, folks, there's some Chuckavision too.
Look at our heroes. Look, with our heroes, there they are.
Spike hairs and tatches. Actually, talking of Chuckle. Sorry. Yes, a bit of a Dick and Dom in the Bungalow thing there. And talking of the chuckles, actually, an email here from Muse who says, Dom, you're growing a goatee tash.
I'm growing a goatee
tash. Look, haven't you seen that?
That'll be. When the cab arrived this morning to take me from the back door to the front door, that's right. Unfortunately, I had overslept and they just woke me up by ringing the doorbell.
Thank you for the email. You get one of these Robbie Williams books. Well done.
Also, we've got another one here. Should we get to write this? Milo, this is from Marie in South Wales. Hello, Marie. Thank you very much for your email. You get one of these books.
Well done.
There you go. Milo, if you could just read that.
Hi, Dick and Dom.
Hi, tell Milo he thinks too much of himself, but he's stunning.
Milo's gone. You get it.
Oh,
get it.
I'll get that. I'll, shall I get that?
You get that. You get it.
Shall I get it?
You get it.
I'll get it. I'll get it. Now, the moose has got a cold. I asked you what we should do to stop his snotty green stuff. Hello? Who's there? Hello? Who's there? Oh, somebody burping really loud. Pardon, burpermeter. I'll give you 10 and a 9 and an 8. No, that's the size of you. Hello, what's your name?
My name's Adam Eastman.
Adam?
Yeah?
Andrew, Adam.
Adam.
Adam, hello, Adam. How are we going to relieve the moose of his killed? I'll put the phone to his ear.
Well, you could put him in a big warm bath, and you could wear a spacesuit and wipe his nose with a tea towel.
Put him in a bath, yeah?
Yeah.
Wearing a spacesuit with a towel on his head. The moose, naughty moose! The moose is really ill, look at that! Look at that! That's dis... Oh! Don't want to see the floor.
Hey?
The moose has been sick on the floor. Don't want to see the floor. Adam, thank you very much. I'm going to give you 7 out of 10 for that. Back to my short, fat, little hairy friend over there.
Yes, thank you very much. Hello, Dickie. Oopsie, there's a man in the bungalow. Hello. Right, time to do something we like to call Dom's Tricky Training. We get one of these horrible, smelly bungalow heads over here. They come over here and we teach them how to do some magic. Yes, can you hear the music? It's beautiful. Who wants to do a magic trick?
Me!
Who wants to do a magic trick?
Me!
Who wants to do magic?
Me!
Sit down.
Me!
Because it's going to be... Harvey!
Harvey.
So I'll tell you what, the badgers need feeding.
Yeah, the badgers need feeding, and so does your mother, so we'll go and do that.
I'll go feed my mother. She's in the kennel outside.
Come on out of here. Off we go.
There we go. OK. Now, Harvey, have we got a magic set to give Harvey? Who am I talking to? Sorry, at the wall. Harvey, would you like to do a magic trick?
Yes.
Well, I'm going to show you the trick first of all, okay, mate? Okay, then you're going to try and work out how it's done, okay? Here it is, okay. Now watch it, stay there. What's that?
A glass.
What's that?
Newspaper.
What's this?
A fire engine.
Correct. All right, then, watch this. It's the disappearing fire engine trick, okay? It's absolutely amazing. What I'm going to do is cover up the fire engine with the glass. And I'm just going to cover up the glass as well with this newspaper. Here we go. Okay, if I lift it up, can you see that? Can you see the fire engine?
Yep.
Okay, glass is still there. Solid table. The fire engine's going to vanish. You ready? Okay, it's solid. There's the fire engine. Okay, watch this. On the count of three, fire engine's going to go. 1, 2. The glass vanished instead, Harvey! Is that good? Did you like that?
Yep.
How's it done?
I know.
Turn around. Can you look shocked? They didn't see. Look shocked. Oh.
That was good, wasn't it?
Yeah. All right, then. OK, do you want to know how to do the trick? OK, I'm going to show you how to do the trick, Harvey. OK, come over here. Come over here. Come around here. Look, where the glass is. Where's the glass?
There.
There it is. OK, Harvey, OK. Well, OK, hand up in the air like that. Good man. OK, stand forward. OK, there's the glass, there's the newspaper, there's the fire engine. It's all to do with misdirection. It looks like I'm going to vanish the fire engine. In fact, I don't. I vanish the glass. Why's your hand up there? Sorry. OK, what you do is you cover it up like this. Right, like that, so it moulds the shape around the glass. Now what you do, you need something soft and cushiony behind the table, all right? And then you put the glass down there, you point towards the fire engine and let it just drop like that out of the glass onto the cushion, all right? You put it at the top and make it go, okay? Do you want to see him do it? Yeah, let's see him have a go. Okay, Harvey, go for it, mate. I'm going to stand here like an amazed spectator. Go on, Harvey. Go on, talk a bit. What are you doing?
I'm making the glass disappear.
No, you're not making the fire engine disappear. Fire engine.
So I'm trying to make the fireman.
Not fireman, there's no fireman here. What are you talking about? Did you watch a different trick? You'll be watching the Quick Trick Show, haven't you? Go on, what are you doing? It's very simple.
What?
Listen, I'm sorry. You've got to pretend you're making the fire engine vanish.
Yeah.
Okay, that's when you drop that down there. Okay, do it again. What are you doing, Harvey?
I'm making the fire engine vanish.
Oh, fantastic. I can't wait. Go on, make the fire engine vanish. Go on.
How on earth do I do that? There.
Yeah. Go on. Yeah, good. Now. Oh, fantastic. OK, now make the fire engine vanish. You said you were going to make the fire engine vanish. Fantastic. This is Harvey, fantastic. You're going to practice that a little bit. Hey, they're coming back with the badges. They're coming back. What are you clapping for? We haven't seen it.
You're clapping the badges. Your mother's well fed now.
Is she? Yeah, she get back at her kennel or is she still chained up?
She's like that.
Good stuff.
How was he?
How are you?
Fine.
Fine, he was fine. He was Jerry Halliwell. Yeah, he was Jerry Halliwell.
Well done, Harvey. Right, now what? It's time for the pants test. What we're going to do first, though, is have a look where your scores are at the moment. So let's have a look at the scoreboard.
Just said go.
There it is. It's the Bungalow points of the Bungalow head. Stanley's on 20.
OK, we've got Edward. He's got 50 Bungalow points. Milo's got 15.
Yes, then there's a bit of Harvey on 8.
OK, and Patrick with 13.
With Jamie on 15 as well. Oi. That means, Harvey, you're going to do the pants dance as well.
Come over here.
Join in with the words if you know them. Come on, they're on the screen.
Yeah, yeah, baby, look at me. Got my hair in my pants. Just like they do in France.
You gotta take a chance.
And do the groovy and the mingles dance. And dance in your pants.
Give it up for Harvey.
Well done, Harvey. Fantastic.
Look at all them at home doing it as well.
You're doing it at home. If you actually do it at home, email us bungalow@bbc.co.uk. Email us if you do it as well.
Send a photo in of yourself doing the pants dance or a video. Get someone to video it and
get out of it.
No! No! Don't throw the pants at us. They've got the smelly stuff on them.
Oh, I'm so hungry, lovey.
Oh, I need food.
We need lots of food. It's been such a long time since we've had a proper meal. Things like potatoes, sweets, carrots. Oh!
Lots of mutton with gravy and roast potatoes with
burgers. I want burgers.
I want whopping pots of chips.
But he's all hungry.
Oh, I love a couple of pancakes.
Mice.
Yeah.
I think it was mice again. Who wants another programme?
Me!
Hey,
a video!
Who wants Rent a Ghost?
Yeah!
Hey, well, we got a video of Rent a Ghost, and all we have to do is just put it inside there, like that.
And everyone's singing along to the theme tune. Here we go!
Oh, don't just hit me.
Oh, my goodness!
You seem to have come out of your sheets.
Where are you? Where's it? Ah, that was my arm! Oh.
Hi! What's going on? It's all finished. Right.
Hold on. Right.
Here's some of the prizes that you guys could be winning here in the Bungalow today.
If you're in third place tomorrow, you'll get a 3-month subscription to the MG Enthusiast magazine, and you can work out how to fix your dream midget. Hello.
Pardon?
Second prize.
Well, get off. Get off.
Is this micro pets?
Hallelujah indeed. And also, if you come first in the Bungalow, you could get this.
TV video thingy and one, two of those thingies. You lot, come over here. You can take your sheets off now. Let's have a look where you all are in the scoreboard. These are the Bungalow heads on Saturday morning on Dick and Dom in the Bungalow. These are their points.
They're a rowdy lot, aren't they? Yeah, there we are. We've got Stanley with 20 points.
Edward's got 50.
Yes!
Milo has got 15.
Jake, Fizz and Milo. And Harvey's got 8.
Patrick's got 30 points.
Jamie's got 15.
There we go.
Harvey's losing with 8, but now the chance for him to gain his points back.
Oh, no, hang on. No, the phone's going.
Is it?
Is it? You better go and get the phone.
Oh, the phone's going. Oh, I don't believe it. Right. Oh, yes, it's Dickie's Dilemmas. Earlier, I asked you to ring in. The moose has got a cold. Look at it. Snotty, snot, snot. I asked you to ring in and tell me what we can do. To stop him having a cold. Hello, who's there? It's Dickie's Dilemmas.
Hello?
Hello.
This is Bradley.
Hello, Bradley. How are you?
Hello, Dick.
Hello. Yes, I'm Dick. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Hello, fine, thanks.
Yeah.
What are we going to do with the moose?
Pardon?
What are we going to do with the moose?
Oh, well, I think you should get your mind kick off first
What?
I think you should get your electric nose ticker first.
Yes.
Put it up his nose, and then put Dilly Dick and Dilly Mum on some cotton bud, and then stick that up his nose. If that doesn't work,
well, did hear a
corks up there.
Didn't hear a word you said, but it sounded very good. 8 out of 10. Well done. Goodbye. Dom?
Yes, thank you very much. Okay, now it's over to Harvey, who's going to try and do Dom's tricky training. Harvey's been pacing up and down. And are you ready, Harvey? Here we are. You need the top hat. Oh, no, hang on, he can't see. Let's just turn it around. There, you can see his eyes now. There you go, fantastic. Hey, can you see all right? Yeah? No, you can't. I'm only joking. All right, now, basically, Harvey's going to do a trick for all you guys. If you work out how it's done, you all get 10 points each, and you get put into a big pit of snakes. If you do the trick well, you get a box of magic tricks.
Ooh.
Like that, yeah? You get a box of magic tricks, and also you get 20 bungalow points. Ooh. Do the trick!
I found two
shush, 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 shush. Okay, he's gonna do the trick. Magic
here
man,
go,
Harvey.
Shut up. Harvey. Harvey's now covering the glass. He's gonna make the fire engine disappear. Underneath the glass is the fire engine. I'm gonna move it forward. There's the fire engine. See the fire engine?
Fire engine.
That's
fire
it.
Engine.
Cover it up with a glass. Ooh. And watch this. On the count of three, you make it disappear. One, two, oh! The glass! Disappeared!
Hey!
Okay, wait.
Milo first.
Where he moved the newspaper, the glass was on the newspaper, he moved it back, the glass fell out behind the thing.
He's got it right!
Come over here into the lift. And what we're gonna do is just open it up, just like that. Oh dear, the lift's broken again. There we are, we're gonna put you inside and send you off to the snakes. See, I'll just press the button. There we go.
Off to the underwater snakes.
See you later.
And we're gonna watch another video while he's on his way down in the lift. Yes, it's time for a bit of our heroes, the Chucker Visions, the Chucker Brothers. Come on, give them
a go. Bow, 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 bow,
bow. Bungalow, 15 minutes left.
Now, listen, all of the bungalow heads are here, apart from one, little Harvey. Now, little Harvey earlier did a magic trick, and if he did it successfully, no one could work it out, it was done, he was going to get a magic set and 20 bungalow points. He failed. Everyone here got 10 bungalow points.
Yay!
And he got thrown into a pit for the snake. And we can go to Harvey now. Harvey!
Watch out, there's one behind you, Harvey!
There's one behind you!
There's one behind you!
Little Harvey.
Shaking.
Oh, poor.
Don't cry, Harvey. It's been Dickie's Dilemmas all morning. Look, the moose has got a snot coming out. It's schnoz. It's got a cold. It was a bit ill earlier as well. I've been asking you to tell me how we're going to relieve its cold. We've had two good callers so far. Let's see who the next one is. Hello, how are you? What's your name?
Lily.
Lily?
Yes, Lily.
Lily. Hello, Lily. Louis Smith, how are you? And what's
Fine.
Your... Good. And what's... What... Oh, there
he is. I hate your Saturday
show. It's not very well. Naughty moose. Not really well. Poorly moose.
Right,
stop it now. How are you going to relieve his problem then, Louis?
Get two bananas, stick them up his nostrils, and then get a peg and stick it on his nose.
Ooh, that's quite a good idea, actually, Louis. Let's see what the moose thinks about that. What do you think about that, Moosey? Go on, Moosey, what do you think about that? He thinks it's absolutely... Right, Louis, it was very good. Oh, I'll put you back up the air. It was very good, but I'm going to give you 6 out of 10 for that. Very good indeed. Thank you so much. Goodbye. But Bradley, who rang in earlier... Bradley, who rang in earlier, who told me a really good result for the Moose's cold, didn't hear a word he said, has won because they gave him 8 out of 10. And Bradley, you've won. Look, exclusive!
A Dick and Dom in the Bungalow t-shirt.
Dick and Dom in the Bungalow t-shirt.
Oi, look at that. Hey, should we roll up?
Start up. The strangely talented, they're unique.
There we are. Yes, it's strangely talented. You guys, is there anyone out there? Have you got a strange talent? Have you? Do you dress up weirdly and do strange things? If so, we want to hear from you. The address to email us is
bungalow. Oh. I sprung that on you. Bungalow at bbc.co.uk. It's bungalow at bbc.co.uk.
Typey, typey. Bungalow at bbc.co.uk. It's got straight salad. Should we meet the first act?
Yes, let's.
Let's do. I've got 10 minutes.
Wait. Before you do that, we've got to give the kids some scoreboards. Guys, how come you're back?
You're in the snakes, Harvey.
Where did you come from?
You're the snakes of
back. Back to the snakes.
He's dead.
Go on, Harvey. No. Don't. Come on, Harvey. Back to the snakes. Harvey, go. Go on. Go back to the snake bit. Honestly, you thought you could join in the fun. No, go on, back there. Good, there we go. Okay, grab your scoreboards, friends. You've got to give these three acts marks out of 10, all right? Nice and clearly next to the act. We want to know what the score is, okay? You're right, there you go.
Okay. I've got a tendency to do this now.
Stroke your beard.
Yeah, stroke your beard. Right, act one, drum roll, please. Act one is Grace, who's going to be an adult tweenie. Unbelievable. Come on, Grace, let's see your adult tweenie act. My word.
Here we go.
Adult tweenie. Take it away, Gracie baby.
I'm Jay. I learned a new word today. Hippolonomous. No, Jay, it's hippopotamus.
I'm leaving in about a year.
I'm doodle.
I'm still wiggling. Put your fingers on your head.
I want to tie my shoelaces, and my mummy was teaching me. I know how to tie my shoelaces. You cross it over, and you do that.
Let everyone at home just see it one more time. Can't do one more little bit for us. Go on, and again.
I know how to tie my shoelaces. You do a cross, and you tie. My mummy taught me how to do my shoelaces.
Right, that's Grace, everyone. Right, Grace, go and get your applause from the bungalow heads. Applause!
Grace. Clap. Come and stand here. Well done, Grace. Amazing talent, kind of. Okay, let's find out how. No, don't write rude words. Don't do that. Okay, 0 out of 10 there, and we got 0 out of 10 there, 6 out of 10 there, plus 7, and 0 there, so 6 plus 7, that's 13 points. Going to be the lowest score I think we've ever had on the bungalow, Grace. Well done, Grace, everyone!
Very funny. Thank you very much, Grace.
Wait. Yep.
Yes, drum roll, please, for the second act. Come on, the second act is Melvin, the performing dolphin.
Yay!
Here's your performance, mate.
Come into the middle.
Come onto your stage. Here we are. This is your stage. Right, off you go. Perform.
Oh, I think I'm going to... Oh, no.
Oh.
Showbiz half.
Naughty dolphin.
Running man.
It's not really going with our choice of music, is it, really, do you think?
Robotics.
I think we should have chosen some more upbeat music, really, don't you? Taken years ago. Should we...
It's good.
What on earth is going on here?
It's good.
Have you ever seen anything like this on television?
Melvin the dolphin. Melvin, well done. Well done, well done, Melvin. Come over here.
Melvin.
Let me shake a flipper.
No!
Ow!
Ow!
Stop it! Bad dolphin.
Naughty dolphin!
Send them out. Back to the swamp, wherever you live.
See? Come and do the scores.
Okay,
scores.
Let's have the scores. Let's have a look. Come on. 10 there. We got 10 there. That's 20. 10 there. 10 there. And 10 there. That's 50 points!
My word! 50 points for the performing dolphin! 50 points! Please, you're gonna like this one. It's Gloria, the impressionist. She does impressions of anyone. Come on, Gloria, take your stage. Right, guys, start with Jamie. Jamie, who do you want her to do an impression of?
Anyone.
Think of someone famous.
Of
course. Who?
Tony Blair.
Education.
All right, Edward, who do you want her to do?
Abraham Lincoln.
Well, I want to bring peace back into America.
That's fair.
All for education. I want to bring peace back into America.
That's great.
Come on,
very
another good. One.
Milo.
Sven Goran Eriksson.
The England manager.
Enrique Johnson one.
He's Finnish, Swedish, German.
Well, I can't do that one, but I can do another accent.
Yeah, go on, go on.
Scottish,
go on.
I know.
Who?
Scottish.
Billy Connolly. What?
Billy Connolly.
I was sitting on the table one day and I found myself stuck on the floor and I didn't know what to do.
Yeah, right. Stanley, go on. What have you got one for us?
Erika Johnson and Sven.
Stanley.
Irish person.
No, there's no such person as an Irish
what about
famous person.
Presenter?
Dom.
Do an impression of me.
Who? Oh, God. Don't impression of me.
What do you mean, Scott? Sorry.
Don't impression of me. Don't impression of me. I've got a nice dimple in me. Right, Chief. And I've got alligator here.
Alligator here.
Yeah, I'll tell you what. We'll give you 30 more seconds just to do back-to-back impressions of anybody you like. Go on.
All right. No, apparently
we're not. Right, enough.
Thank you very much.
It's
quite an impressionist. We got 10 there, we got 9 there, we got 8. It's 45.
45? So that means the winner.
Melvin,
the performing dolphin! Thank you, Gloria, very much indeed. The performing dolphin's going to be back for the Strangely Talented final.
Come back in, Melvin.
Oh, Melvin, well done. That means you are now on the leaderboard to try and win this, the mounted fruitcake.
Well done, Melvin. Well done. Off you go. Back to your flipper.
We'll see you. Thank you very much. Yes.
It's the beginning of the end of the show.
It's the beginning of the end of the show. We're nearly at the end. And we have to find out which one of these bungalow heads has got the least amount of points.
So, guys, throw down your pens, throw down your boards, come and line up here. We're going to find out who the loser is. Come on, over here.
Chop, chop. Line up.
I'm here. Line up. Roll up.
Okay, line up there.
Nice straight line.
Facing this way.
Nice straight line. Come on.
Come on. Nice straight line. That includes all of you.
Right, everybody ready? Okay.
Who's it going to be?
Oh, we need Harvey back from the snakes. There he is. Oh, he's got snake juice all over him. Right, who's the loser?
Who's it going to be?
Is it Stanley? Is it Patrick?
Oh, no.
Is it Jamie? Is it Miley? It's Harvey!
Harvey, mate, you just come back from the snake and now you're off the toilet. Come with me. Get into the toilet. You're going to get gunged.
Harvey is going to get gunged as the lab attacks in about a minute's time. Guys, come and sit down here. We're going to check the scoreboard now to see what positions you're on. You can watch in a minute, yeah? You can see him getting gunged. Let's have a look at the scoreboard, see what the scores are like after Saturday's Dick and Dom in the bungalow. You can see that Edward's in the lead with 60 points. Go on, Edward. Woo. Just behind that, there's Patrick with 40. Stanley's got 30. Marlo's got 25. Jamie's got 25. And Harvey, as you saw, losing with 8.
There you go. Wiki, wiki, wah, wah.
Wiki, 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 woo, wah. What?
No, you can't. Of course you can't. There we go. It's nearly the end of the show. And these guys are going to be back fresh and bright and early tomorrow morning. It's going to be a Sunday morning.
They're going to be sleeping over in the bungalow tonight, so you best find your PJs in a bit, guys.
Yeah, you had a good time, guys?
Yeah.
Fantastic.
Hold on a minute. Stanley just yawned.
Stanley?
Did you just yawn?
No, you know you're a bad man for yawning.
Is that because you're tired or is that because you're bored?
I'm tired.
Very good. Correct answer. Five points.
He's not tired. For yawning. Yes. Well done. What's your best bits of the show been, guys?
You guys are so great.
You're just trying to flatter us now.
You guys are so great.
Sit down. Us guys?
Yeah, you guys. Yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you what.
Dickhead.
No.
Very quickly, before
hang
you
away, go. We got to apologise for that. Sorry, if there's anyone that... sorry.
Very quickly, before you go, right, tomorrow, we're going to find out what the England score is tonight, yeah? 6-0, yeah. England kick-off against Slovakia. Let's all have a prediction. Whoever gets it right tomorrow will get 20 bungalow points. And Patrick, what do you think the score's
going to be? I reckon Slovakia are going to win 15-0.
15-0? My word, Stanley.
I reckon the score's going to be
2-0 to England.
I bet.
3-1.
Hey, very
Edward.
Good.
Can I change mine?
1-0 and Patrick.
No, it's Jamie.
Can I change mine? 2-1. 2-1.
Well done, guys.
Okay, we'll find out what the score is tomorrow. Good luck to England tonight.
And now we can cross over to the toilet to find out how Harvey's getting on. It's time to go over to him and find out how he's getting on in the toilet. Harvey, gun yourself.
Gun you.
Go.
He's lost. He's in.
That must be cold.
That's been another Dick and Dom in the bungalow. The way Saturday morning television should be.
Hey, listen, I tell you what, we're going to be there Sunday morning for the way Sunday morning television should be.
Should be, yes.
And we're going to be back.
Yes, you're going to be back. Unfortunately.
Tomorrow morning from 9 o'clock, set your alarm clocks only on the CBBC channel. You best be there.
Come on, guys.
Let's dance.
Yeah, did you? Yay. That's the best place to be. So we'll see you bright and early tomorrow morning.
Let's go anywhere. Come on.
We'll see you later.
Bye.
See you later.
Come on.